in 5 horrible months, the enemy, like an octopus, has stretched his tentacles across vast spaces of the Pacific, devouring prize after prize to satiate his appetite for conquest. But the day after Corregidor's fall comes the Battle of the Coral Sea. American carrier planes pounce on a Japanese invasion force out to engulf Port Moresby and cut off Australia. For the first time in history, men of war fight it out without once sighting each other. When the battle is over, the Japanese retreat. One of their carriers has been sunk. 2 others are badly damaged. The United States loses the carrier Lexington. Few know it, but the tide is turning. Out from America, across the enormous ocean waste, transports stream toward Australia with supplies and men. The buildup begins. Personalities who will dominate the coming struggle emerge. General MacArthur in Australia, and in Pearl Harbor, Admiral Nimitz. As the Japanese prepare to strike again, Nimitz makes a fateful decision. He gathers available ships together in the Central Pacific, deducing that Midway is the enemy's objective. Nimitz appoints Admiral Spruance to command a carrier task force in the defense of Midway Island, 1,000 miles west of Pearl Harbor, 3,500 miles east of Tokyo. Midway itself sends incessant patrols in search of the elusive Japanese. Massive forces are converging on this pinpoint in the ocean, which the enemy wants as his eastern outpost. For America, it is the last century between Japan and Hawaii. The Pacific War is focused on a coral atoll, 6 miles in diameter. Day after day, hour after hour, planes search and search and search. And then, through a gap in the clouds, Japanese troop transports. But what the spotting plane does not see is the Japanese striking force, which outnumbers the Americans in every class. Battleships, cruisers, carriers, destroyers, planes. The same carriers that raped Pearl Harbor are headed for Midway. Akagi, Kaga, Soryu, Hiryu. Aboard the flagship Akagi, Admiral Nagumo, who directed the attack on Pearl Harbor, plots his new mission. Execute an aerial attack on Midway, destroying all enemy forces in preparation for landing. The pilots assigned to the task are also veterans of December 7th. The elite of Fleet Air Arm, the pride of the Imperial Navy. Confident, fanatical, they prepare to slaughter the Marines defending Midway and add the island to their unbroken string of conquests. Midway blazes, but Midway stands. Far at sea, Admiral Spruance increases speed to 25 knots and prepares to close the Japanese. Admiral Fletcher, officer in tactical command, orders, proceed southwesterly and attack enemy carriers when definitely located. The tireless search planes hit the jackpot. The enemy carriers are finally located. Midway has been badly hit, but Midway comes back fighting. So loaded with fighting equipment is this stationary aircraft carrier, little room is left for its natives, the Goonie Birds. Midway hits the Japanese with all it has. Every available land-based plane is sent against the enemy fleet.